Hi everyone, I'm Amalia. I'm a visual artist and digital humanities expert with Navigating Art. I'm here to talk with you today about how new digital solutions can help contribute to a more equal and transparent art world. New ways of exploring and discovering art are needed more than ever. This change also reveals a rare opportunity in the midst of a crisis for us to reevaluate the inequalities in the art world and use the migration of art online to reorient its values and uses. Between unexpected lockdowns and museum closures and virtual gallery nights, the way we experience art is changing rapidly. Online art archives like ours can host millions of data entries on artists, artworks, events, and primary sources, all vetted by a well-known authority. Today, a lot of invaluable archival materials are inaccessible, hidden in boxes and basements, and potentially vulnerable to damage and degradation over time. Unless brought to light in a well-structured and accessible format, such information will likely be gradually lost, available, if at all, only to specialized art historians. Digital archives situate artworks in the social and historical context of why and how a piece was created, and at the same time, preserves them and even enhances their value. Navigating Art, launched in April 2021, has developed a new online platform which allows its users to digitize, publish, and explore trustworthy information about art. We envision a more transparent and equal art world, and we want our contributors to have a lasting impact on the digital humanities.
Nikolai Bon, one of our founders, is here to tell you about how we aim to accomplish this through three innovative solutions.
Our first solution, the archival solution, supports the process of storing and capturing archival materials, as well as interlinking them. Our cataloging solution then supports the process of creating a catalogue raisonnés. And finally, our publishing solution, which allows to share these information in the public domain.
Dependent on archival materials for their completion, a catalogue raisonnés is a comprehensive publication of every single artwork an artist has ever made within the context of art historical events.
The Navigating Art software is supporting one of the few catalogue raisonnés projects on the work of a person of color. The Romar Bearden Digital Catalogue Raisonnés is an ongoing project by the Romar Bearden Foundation in collaboration with the Wittgenstein Platna Institute in New York.
Deidre Harris-Kelly of the Bearden Foundation is currently researching the incredible work of Nanette Rohan, Bearden's wife. She played an essential role in preserving his work. Her advocacy and effort is what has made the catalogue raisonnés production possible. Nanette was a pioneer of dance in addition to being president of the Bearden Foundation until her death in 1996.
Most of art history has been written by select few who don't represent the great diversity of artists in this world, especially women and people of color. The contemporary digital transition is an unprecedented opportunity for artists of all backgrounds to begin writing their own histories. This also allows projects with less monetary support and perhaps less market value to come to fruition.
The digital approach to catalogue raisonnés creation becomes increasingly popular. In contrast to its analog form, which requires production costs up to 1 million euros, the digital catalogue raisonnés only requires a fraction of the production costs and at the same time is continuously editable and extendable, as well as shareable via the internet with everyone for free.
A catalogue raisonnés can greatly influence the legacy and reputation of an artist and contributes heavily to their market value. It also solidifies importance in museums and collections and establishes permanence in art history. If you are an artist, you may be wondering, how can I benefit from the advantages of digitization? Digital archiving not only helps you solidify your legacy long after you are gone, it also helps you organize your studio as a business. Starting to archive your work now will make cataloging a realistic endeavor in the future. If you are an artist who has experienced exclusion because of your gender, race, economic background, or otherwise, we would argue that you should take charge and put serious consideration into preserving your own legacy online. Why wait for a biased art market to decide whether your work merits a place in art history? Instagram may be useful in the now, but it is fleeting and the fame can be ephemeral. Archiving, on the other hand, is crucial in ensuring an artist receives the long-term recognition their career warrants.
So many people rely on trustworthy art-centric information. The act of repatriation, for example, which aims to return an artwork to its origin that had either been stolen or illegally bought, relies heavily on authentic information to understand the provenance and history of an artwork and see where it should be returned to.
We had the chance to speak with gallerist Nathan Vonk from Sullivan Goss in California about his perspective on transparency in the art world.
So from our perspective, it's absolutely essential if the art industry is going to build an audience and expand its audience to create greater and greater transparency so that people can see exactly why things have the value they do, why they're important in this way, and to feel as though they're absolutely comfortable spending money on a piece of art and knowing why it has the value that it does.
Additionally, digitization and online project sharing are drastically changing research methods. Underfunded professors and students who do not have the time or means to travel not only benefit from digital projects, but can also conduct more in-depth research remotely.
Now I would like to introduce Véronique. She's from the Women Art Dealers Digital Archives, which is a new project that examines and evaluates women art dealers' contributions to today's art world and the larger art history canon.
WADA aims to correct the historiographical marginalization of women art dealers and cement the role of these women as agent of change instead of exchange. We will provide a centralized resource where traditional research may be conducted and innovative approaches to analyzing conventional data may be tested and applied. Because of its geographical footprint, WADA will also disrupt the Western-centric axis of the contemporary art market, allowing for a better understanding of the essential cultural role played by these women in emerging art markets, such as Asia and Africa. Through the power of digitization and open access, WADA will bring to the fore the agency these women had as business entrepreneurs, but more importantly, envision that as a largely autonomous interactive digital platform, WADA users will be able to collaboratively engage with colleagues across the disciplines to bring more transparency to the study of the art market.
Another very ambitious vision by writer, filmmaker, and art historian Nana Aforiata Aim is the creation of a digital cultural encyclopedia of Africa, which will map and archive both historical and contemporary arts and culture across Africa. Aforiata Aim has been a trailblazer in promoting the arts in and outside of Africa. One of her many successes includes curating the groundbreaking Ghana Pavilion at the Venice Biennale in 2019, which included work by the acclaimed Ghanaian artist El Anatsui, pictured here.
Quoting from the New York Times article, the encyclopedia will consist of an open-source internet platform for documenting past, present, and future African arts and culture, an ambitious undertaking. The cultural encyclopedia aims to change perceptions of the continent and help alleviate the frustration of African cultural producers concerned that their rich histories have been lost or forgotten over the decades because they lack good archives.
As more and more projects are digitized and interrelated online, readers will be able to see and interact with information which brings to light the significance of an artist they had never even heard of.
Art communities rely on integration, critique, and support.
In the past, most of these projects have been supported by large foundations or collectors and auction houses looking to boost the market value of an artist. But the new digital approach means the significance of a catalogue raisonné can support the needs and interests of artists and the public too.
So as we've talked about, the more accessible digital approach to publishing and exploring art contributes to the long-term recognition of artists of all backgrounds and the production of a wider diversity of projects. Our vision is to improve art data access, contribute to more equality and transparency, and support endless, fascinating links between different artists' practices and histories.